All right, let me say this once and for all. I will not serve as vice president for either party in 2024. Oh, phone calls. Donald Trump hasn't announced whether he's going to run for president again in 2024, but he seems to have decided on one thing. Mike Pence won't be his running mate. Quote, "I don't think the people would accept it," Trump said in an interview with the Washington Examiner of making Pence his VP pick again in 2024, adding this, "Mike and I had a great relationship, except for the very important factor that took place at the end. We had a very good relationship. I haven't spoken to him in a long time," end quote. Now that should surprise exactly no one who has been paying attention to politics over the past 18 months. Trump has never forgiven Pence for refusing to overturn the election results during the counting of Electoral College votes on January 6, 2021. Worth noting here, there's no constitutional role for Pence to have done that. Just saying. Quote, "I don't want to be your friend anymore if you don't do this," Trump told Pence of overturning the election. According to the book Peril by Bob Woodward and Robert Costa, "I won't be your friend anymore." Huh. Now, who Trump might pick as his VP nominee is not a purely theoretical conversation. Trump is showing literally every sign of running for president again, and there's been little to suggest that he would face any serious competition for the nomination. Recently, he won a 2024 straw poll at the 2022 Conservative Political Action Conference, and he won it overwhelmingly. So, we now know Trump isn't going to pick Pence again, but who might he pick? Well, let's go through a few of the most obvious options. Sidebar, while vice presidential nominees are often runners-up for the party's nod, Trump is not the kind of person to forgive and forget, which means that if any of these people wind up challenging Trump directly for the GOP nomination in 2 years, they are likely off his VP list. Ron DeSantis. This would be the dream ticket for many MAGA loyalists. The Florida governor is the most liked of the politicians not named Trump within the party, and he hails from a large swing state. One catch? DeSantis has not been as willing to grovel at the prospect of a 2024 Trump candidacy as some other ambitious Republicans have. Nikki Haley. You can count on one hand the number of people who left the last administration on good terms with Trump. Haley, who served as the U.S. ambassador to the United Nations during the first part of Trump's White House tenure, is actually one of them. Now, since then, their relationship has had its ups and downs. Whose hasn't? Plus, as an Indian American woman, she would be a different sort of candidate than Republicans have been nominating for their national ticket in recent elections. Tim Scott. While the South Carolina senator has been occasionally willing to criticize Trump, he's also remained in the former president's good graces. Scott has already said he would endorse Trump if the former president ran again in 2024. And Scott would be a history-making pick for Trump as the first black candidate on a national Republican ticket. Glenn Youngkin. Sure, Youngkin has only been the governor of Virginia for a few months now, I get it. But he proved in that 2021 campaign that there is a way to thread the needle between the party's Trump-loving base on one hand and the suburban voters who were turned off by the former president's bombast on the other. Youngkin also discovered an issue, education and the role parents should play in it, that could well deliver Republicans the majority in the House and Senate this November. Ted Cruz. Remember that Trump loves redemption stories. Trump views everything through the lens of TV and ratings, and a redemption story always draws in the viewers. So what better storyline is there in 2024 than if Trump picks the runner-up in the 2016 Republican primary who pointedly refused to endorse him at the convention before coming around to eventually support him? For people who say Cruz wouldn't accept the vice presidential nomination, I can only assume you have never met Ted Cruz. Josh Hawley. The freshman Missouri senator joined the charge to contest the electoral college counts in Pennsylvania and Arizona on January 6th, which made him a favorite of the former president and his most loyal MAGA allies. And at just 42 years old, Hawley would likely leap at the chance to be on the national ticket, win or lose. So who Trump will pick is a fun parlor game, admittedly, that we will play for the next 2 years, but don't get it twisted. VP picks almost never make any difference as to whether the top of the ticket wins or loses. Voters vote for president, with VP only a minor concern most of the time. And that is The Point. We make New Point episodes every Tuesday and Thursday. Check them all out.